Hi there. Welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I want to show you how you can keep your inbox organized with email aliases. So I'm going to show you in Gmail how to create an alias on your account, and I'm going to show you two different ways to do this. The first way will be a permanent one, where maybe you have multiple emails and you're tired of just logging into each account. You can have all those forwarded to your main account, and you can even reply from that one account. That's going to save you a bunch of time. The other way, a temporary way, would be just about keeping your inbox cleaner from spam. And that's using these temporary aliases where you can sign up, just changing it slightly, and then it can be all filtered out and organized in your email. So those are the two things I want to show you with how to use these aliases today on Teachers Tech. I have two different accounts open here. You can see this one right here and this one. These are both demo accounts. I want this one right here to be my main account that I want to be able to send mail from that other account without logging into this one. So this is where I'm going to add the alias to this one. So I'll be able to send from either one. I'll also show you how you can actually connect your, have all the messages sent over to this one as well. But let's just start with being able to send as the other one. So what we do need to do first is go up to our settings right here. So if we click the settings and then see all settings, and then we go over to accounts and import. And if we look down, we have a few different options. Send mail as, this is where it's going to allow us to send as another, depending on how many emails, we can put like 99 emails and we'd be able to select from each one. And so I'm going to go ahead and add another email address here. So I'm just going to click here. So I'm just going to change the name here. So it says demo, and I'm going to paste in the email of the other one. And it's just Teachers Tech Demo 1. The difference is just the number one between the two emails. I want to make sure I have this checked because this is going to treat it as an alias here. And you can learn more to see all the options if you unclick it or click it, depending what you want. So I'm going to go to next step here. If I was part of a work domain or a school, this might be a little different at this step where it will ask for a password. But in this case, all I have to do is send the verification. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. You can see there's a code I could enter. But what I can do if I go over to the email, it's right here. It just got sent here. All I have to do, I could put this number in, but you can just click the code here. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit confirm just like this. And now, if I just return back over to my other email, that's all confirmed. So I'm just going to move back to the main one that I'm on. You can see this right here. It's unverified. So I'm just going to refresh this here. And right now, it's verified. So I can make some changes here. So what do I want as default? So I could actually make this the default here, if I didn't want my address being used for people to see it and I just wanted to have the different alias there, I could make that the default so I don't even have to think of it. But you can also change it down here, reply from the same address, the message that you want to send. So if someone's, I could reply with it if that came, if that was coming from it. But what I like to do a lot of time, if I go to compose now, so if I click on compose, notice now, now here's the original one because that's the default. If I drop down, I have the option of sending my email from the other one here. So if you can go, you don't have to log in to send the emails from another account. You can just have all these as your aliases and you can have 99 of them to be selecting what email do you want to send from. So that's how you can quickly add that. The other thing I want to point out, if you did want to check your mail from other accounts, you can add the mail account here. So same thing, just go ahead, enter your email address that you're wanting to enter and you go through, link the, you can have some options here, what way you wanna import it, but then you connect it and then you'll be able to get your emails over there to that one as well. I wanted to focus more on just the with the alias of sending, being able to send from the different ones. So give that a try. Now let's move on to the other alias I was going to show you, and that's using the temporary ones. Maybe if you're signing up on a lot of different shopping or blogs, I'll show you how you can really keep your email clean with these methods. You know how we're being bombarded with giving our emails all the time, whether we want to sign up for a member like this and we hit join us and then we put our email address in and then our inbox just gets full of all these different things, whether it be for shopping or signing up for blogs or all these different ones. So I want to show you now how we can control this, keep this organized with a temporary alias inside Gmail. So I'm just back in this email here and I'm just going to create one really quick for you. And then we'll sign up with this to this Nike one and see what happens. So I'm just going to go up to show search options here. And I'm going to create an alias here, a temporary alias. And now I got to move down. It's not going to be from, it's going to be to. So this email right here that I'm going to use, this is the main one that I'm going to use here. So teacherstechdemo@gmail.com. That's what the email is. But to help with cleaning things up and filtering, I'm going to add something here. So plus, what am I going to add? I'm going to add a plus, and this is going to be for shopping. So any site that has to do with shopping, I'm going to be using this, and then I can create a filter to tell what I want to have happen to this. So I'm going to go down and create a filter. And what do I want to have happen? Well, if it was a junk place, if I didn't really want the emails in my inbox at all, I could just say if anything comes from there, automatically delete it. So I don't even have to see it. It will just get automatically deleted. Maybe it'll be important. I could start. And you can see all these different options. So what I want to have happen? Well, I want it to maybe go into a certain category. So I could say updates. Now that's just random. I could pick a different one. I don't think that really matches. But I can apply more than one thing too. So maybe I want to be able to buy a label. I'm going to create a new label. So I could have lots of labels, one for blogs, one for shopping. This one's going to be for shopping, and I'm going to hit create. So if an email comes from this right here, so teacherstechdemo+shopping@gmail.com, it's going to get this label applied to it and be put in this update. So I'm just going to go ahead and create this filter. Just like that. And now I'm going to go over to Nike here and I'm going to paste this in. So teachers tech demo plus shopping. Let's see what happens. We're going to hit continue here. And notice right away, it's saying there was a code sent to teachers tech demo. And I have 20 so many seconds and I'm going to go to it. And let's look right away in updates. I see it here because I told it to go to updates. Here's your one-time code. And if I take a look in the shopping, here it is here, label shopping, and I have this one-time code because that was the other place that I told it to go. So imagine if you wanted to sign up for stuff and you just wanted the information deleted, you could have that as the option. So right away with your inbox, you can really keep things a lot cleaner by adding these temporary aliases to this. And you can create more and more and more. You don't have to use the labels like I showed you there. That's just an option. But you can have all those different things. Take a look at all the different ways you could organize those emails of all the places that you're signing up for. So I hope you like this little tips on using the aliases to keep your inbox organized. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.